Daytime Baseball here on MLB Network. Today, the finale of this quick two-game series between the LA Dodgers and the Houston Astros. It's Interleague Baseball next on MLB Network. Lance McCullers, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really been struggling lately. In his last three starts, he has a whip of over 1.50. Lots of base runners, lots of hits, and lots of walks, and that doesn't add up to very good performances. So he's going to look to turn things around in this one here today.
Here's Mookie Betts, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Now here's the first offering. And afternoon baseball on MLB Network is underway. Fellas, taking a look at these Astros entering play here this afternoon. They come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest three-game winning streak.
Yeah, Matty, dropping their last game. Now they find themselves at 500 again. They got to find a way to get on a hot streak. You cannot continue to go peaks and valleys throughout the course of this season and ride that 500 line all year. At some point, you're going to have to take 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10 to get this going in the right direction.
Now the 2-0. Our temperature, hot but not overly hot, 87 degrees here at first pitch. Now the 3-0 offering. And that one misses as well, so it's a poor start here this afternoon as it's a four-pitch walk to get things going.
Wow, if that's not a strike, I don't know what is. I know these subs have a tough job. I get it. We'll see if he gets the next borderline call or if there are any makeup calls coming up.
Now at the plate here is David Fletcher. The average for him entering play sits down in the 250s. From the stretch and too high with the cut fastball, it's 1-0 now.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here, just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
The 1-0 home. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. The 1-1. Betts is on the move. He swings and misses. Throw down. Perfect throw, and they got him at second.
They're showing they're not afraid to be aggressive on the base path so far in this one. But we'll see if this caught stealing slows that down a bit. Managers never like to run into outs, so they might play it a little safer going forward.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Bounce to first. He's got it. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Bases are empty here with two away. And the next hitter will be the right-handed bat of Anthony Rendon. Here's the first pitch.
Nope. Ball one.
Ball one. Two out, nobody on. Two balls and no strikes to Anthony Rendon.
Hey, not a good spot to be, down 2-0. This guy has some serious pop at the plate. I'm expecting a big hack here.
A strike and it's 2-1. Into the windup and the pitch.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off him.
Smoked on the ground up the middle. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, and now the Astros will go to work for the first time. No score. Trevor Bauer. A California-born right-hander is on the mound. What do we need to know here, Danny?
This guy here is one of the top strikeout pitchers in all of baseball. Over 200 strikeouts in the season. And this day and age where we don't see pitchers go that deep into games and pitch well over 200 innings, that's saying something. If this guy is on, it could be lights out and lots of K's.
So now into the box is Kyle Tucker. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And he'll look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. Dero, Danny, this L.A. Dodger ball club as they enter play here this afternoon. They come in looking to make it 2 in a row as they were winners last time out.
Yeah, Matty, I know we're getting ready for game 2, but yesterday, man, road trip got off to a great start. They pounded the baseball, pitched, played defense. This team comes in riding high into game 2.
Down the left field line and hard hit. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Wow, he almost blew that fastball by him, but he shows some quick hands to catch up to it and drive it down the opposite line. Didn't keep it fair by much, but he did, and that's a nice two-bagger.
Into the box, Miles Straw. And he'll take a look at ball one. 268 the average for him coming in. 6 home runs and 47 RBIs. Astros center fielder ahead with a 2-0 count. Time for a look at the umpires working this one. Behind the plate is Darryl Parker.
Well, Dero, Darryl Parker behind the dish, and you never really know what you're going to get from this guy.
Yeah, sometimes, and I'd hate to be mean and say he flips a coin back there because that's not the case. But as an offensive player, you have to find a consistent zone. You just can't.
Fletcher will stay with it as he backs up and puts it away. One gone.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Yordan.
So now here is Yordan Alvarez. He enters play in the hunt for the league's home run crown, but he'll have some work to do down the stretch. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Into right field, that's a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Hey, after that hit right there, Dero, that extends his hitting streak to 6 games.
Yeah, no doubt about it. 6 days in a row with knocks will help you sleep better at night, Dan.
And that'll bring up Alex Bregman as he swings and misses at a first-pitch fastball, 0-1. His numbers against Trevor Bauer, just a couple of matchups, no hits in 2 at-bats. Runners are at first and third, one away. Pitch is mishandled behind the plate and it bounces away. So the lead runner holds on, but the trailer will take second. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
The 3-1 pitch is taken for strike 2. Hit down the line at first. Oh, a diving stop. The throw to first. Hey now.
A really nice play by the first baseman right there. Two parts of this play. Does a great job of knocking it down with a dive and then a good feed and a flip to the pitcher, just like you work on it in spring training, PFP, pitcher's fielding practice.
So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa, as the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. 22 home runs on the ledger for him so far this year. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. The 1-1. Swings through it for strike number two.
He's going to step out of the box, adjust his batting gloves, and pray he gets the exact same pitch as that one. Because if it comes again, we like to refer to that one in the biz as a cement mixer.
Just hung in there on that one.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
He struck him out, and it could have been worse. The inning over with only a run coming across to score. It's quite possible the humidity has finally taken its toll on some of the fans. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. New inning set to get underway, and that brings up the former National League MVP, Cody Bellinger. First pitch on its way, as he'll try and hold off the swing, but this one's in there for strike one. Grounder down the line at third. And he misses there, 1-2.
That's great recognition right there on the part of the hitter. Not many guys lay off that one. That was a classic strikeout pitch, the 0-2, good change up with some depth.
Here comes the 1-2.
Regardless of the result right here, to be down 0-2 and work it back to an even count, gotta feel like it's a win for the offense.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Another full count pitch home. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. Here now is Will Smith. Past meetings against Lance McCullers, he's 1-for-2. Ready to deal, here comes the first pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Now the pitch. Smith is a player referred to as clutch by teammates, coaches, and of course the media. He seems to find himself in pressure situations often, and it's hard to find many instances where those moments have gotten the best of him. It just appears he really relishes the big spot. The 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone. Digging in will be Edwin Rios. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. First pitch of the AB now. Here comes the 0-1. Down low, two balls and a strike. And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin the wind if he starts looking for it in there.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Next up is Max Muncy, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll enter play here with that average down in the low 200s. 17 home runs and 55 driven in. Tried to pull that one back, but he couldn't do it, and it's 0-2 now. Rios is off of first with two away. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. One left for LA. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. His numbers against Trevor Bauer, not a big sample size, 0-1. Brantley. Now the first pitch. As he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
Here's the 1-1. Now a fastball. Oh, look below the knees, but he rings him up anyway, and there's one gone.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
In now, Alberto Ibarra. As he takes a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Well, they got to him in the first inning, which is huge, but he looks a lot more settled into this ball game right now. He's not the kind of pitcher you want to let get into a groove out there.
The windup and the 0-1. On, could we see another strikeout here? It's 0-2 now. Ibarra, a native of the Dominican Republic. This is his first year at the big league level. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
The second baseman, Chris Taylor.
Into the box now, Chris Taylor. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Taylor behind 0-2 the count.
Hey, that's the modern game right now, north-south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east-west we came up playing.
One ball and two strikes to count. Ready on 1-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Top of the third set to get underway. And up next, the exciting left-handed bat of Andrew Benintendi. Now here it comes.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
0-2, the count to Benintendi.
You got to go into battle mode after falling down 0-2 and find a way to work yourself back to even.
Shooting for that low inside corner, but he missed with it. 1-2. And that misses. 2-2. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone.
That's just quality pitching right there for that strikeout. Some guys are real good low ball hitters, but more often than not, keeping the ball down is going to lead to a lot of success on the mound.
To the plate now, Nick Ahmed. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Comes in with an average of 265. 14 homers, and he's driven in 45. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. The Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Ooh-wee, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Well, this lineup obviously doesn't get to see this guy very often because he's over in the other league, and it's really showing. He's pitching really well right now, and I'm sure these hitters are plenty happy they don't have to face him multiple times this year.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's got the average of 285 here to start play. 21 homers and 66 driven in. A swing and a ground ball to third, but a foul ball, 1-1. In there, 1-2 now. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. The 2-2. David Fletcher would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a liner. But this is going to land foul, so they'll tee it up again. 3-2. Rounded back up the middle. Taylor has it. Over to first, and that retires the side. So they go down without a whimper here. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. Houston leads this one 1-0. Corey Lee digging in now. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Bauer into his motion. Here comes the first pitch. As he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Five straight strikeouts now, and there's one gone.
Man, he is looking flat out unhittable on the mound right now. That's five straight punchouts. I love it, but I think he might want to get his defense involved at some point so they don't fall asleep.
So now to the plate, Kyle Tucker, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Second shot now, he doubled to start out the home first. This one is launched. Look at this. And gone. An absolute bomb. A solo shot down the line in right. 19th home run for him on the season. And the Astros have taken a 2-0 lead.
When you're facing an elite starter, you know runs are going to be at a premium. I don't know if this shakes the starter's confidence, but you know what it does? It certainly boosts the confidence of the guys in your lineup.
At the plate, Miles Straw. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. And he falls behind now, 2-0. And it's fouled away. Nip the corner. 2-2. One out, nobody on. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw gets him. Two down. Next up is Yordan Alvarez, a base hit in his first trip. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
Wouldn't mind a pitcher expanding the zone a little bit more and using his aggressiveness against him.
Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
You got to cover the whole plate now after letting him steal two strikes on the inside half.
Got him swinging, and that's the third out. Astros get a run here courtesy of the solo homer. We're through three here in the Space City. It's now 2-0 Houston. All set for the start of the fourth, and set to go is the second baseman, David Fletcher.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Tucker moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. And stepping in, Anthony Rendon. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First offering. Oh, look out! Hot shot to third, and there are two away. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Cody Bellinger. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
One ball, no strikes to count. Loud contact there, but it's well foul. Good break on the knuckle curve, but he missed with it. 2-1. Not Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're still down. It's 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up Alex Bregman.
The third baseman, Alex Bregman.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one, no strike.
Now the 1-0.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Now a swing by Bregman and a ball hit well to deep left. It's up and out of here into the archways. It's a solo shot for Alex Bregman. 32 now for the season, and the Astros have taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Here's Carlos Correa now, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. Ball two now.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
And that catches the outside corner. It's 2-1.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Pound two balls in, and then get right back outside. Nice pitch.
A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And this is going to be a foul ball.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Carlos Correa is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning.
Michael Brantley.
Here's Michael Brantley. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's 0-for-1 thus far. On the ground to the left side. Ahmed showing off his range. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
Boy, there's a quality infield base hit right there. That kind of reminded me of the old Yankees shortstop Derek Jeter on that jump throw.
Hey, that's why this is the pros. Back in the day, that's a knock all day long. But up here, guys are making those plays, at least making you think about them. That's an amazing play by the shortstop to leave his feet and at least make this close.
At the plate now, Alberto Ibarra. as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. Three runs, five hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The
2-0. Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
Three and one.
Now that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turn to the slider. You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
Swung on, and this ball is hammered. Forget about it. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line in left. Home run number 9 on the year as the Astros will open up a 5-0 lead.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Standing in now, Chris Taylor.
Second baseman.
As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. And, ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1. Grounded to third. Rendon is there. Throw in time at first for out number 2. So two out, nobody on. And that brings Corey Lee to the plate. First pitch coming. Here it is. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's 0-1.
I guess the game plan from the offensive standpoint today coming into this one was they were going to work the counts. They've been super patient at the plate in the early goings of this game, and they've got the lead looking for more.
Behind 0-2 now. A ball and two strikes.
When he's pitching effectively, usually that two-seam fastball is moving quite a bit, but here it's just kind of flat and straight. Could be a big part of the reason why he's getting knocked around.
Hit softly down the line at first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So two home runs in the inning lead to 3 runs on the scoreboard. On to the top of inning number 5 we go. The Astros lead it 5-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the 5th.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And he told me he feels like they're being too patient at the plate right now. Too much of the time they're finding themselves in disadvantaged counts like 0-2 and 1-2. And that's basically never a formula for success. He said they're getting a lot of strikes to swing at, so the emphasis the rest of the game has to be to jump on those strikes early in the at-bat.
Thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the 5th. And that brings up Will Smith. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A ball and no strikes.
Ball one, no strikes.
And here's a sinker that had a little bit too much dart to it there as it just about came in and nailed him.
You know, sometimes it takes a pitcher a few pitches to get going, but those two pitches weren't even close. Falls behind in the count 2-0. It's time to start getting locked in.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-1 home. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Made a miss on the off-speed pitch that time. Will Smith is retired to kick off the inning.
Edwin.
Striding forward now is the DH. Edwin Rios worked a walk his first time up. Here's the pitch.
Nope, that's down.
Hit in the air to right center field. This ball is carrying well. Back it goes, and it is out of here. Solo shot to right center. His first home run of the season. As they get on the scoreboard here, it's 5-1.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. And this will be fouled away.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way in the big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle, reined in. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Those jump throws are always some of the most exciting plays you'll see. So here it is again with Showtrack. Shows off some great range, and it's still somehow able to get a lot behind the throw as his momentum was taking him the other way. Not everybody can make that play. And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi. And this will be fouled away. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ballgame. Here it comes.
One ball, one strike.
This is skied into short left center. Here comes Brantley. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. The Dodgers do get one back on the solo home run. Middle of the afternoon here in the Lone Star State. It's the Astros 5 and the Dodgers 1. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Kyle Tucker.
Yeah, he absolutely torched a fastball his last time up. Pretty much a no-doubter, so he's got to be feeling pretty confident right here.
As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Nothing in one count. Here it comes.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame. So the next to bat will be Miles Straw. He grounded out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
The windup and the 0-1. And he looks at a ball, 1-2.
Man, the pitcher let the guy off easy right there. That 0-2 pitch wasn't even close. I'd rate that as a non-competitive pitch.
It's a 5-1 game here in inning number 5. And he punches out another one. Make it 9 for the ball game.
Pretty impressive back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
Alvarez.
That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Fastball called strike. 1-2. And he fouls this one off. Two out, nobody on. And he missed with it up and in to even things at 2-2. Good eye to lay off the knuckle curve that time, and he makes it a full count. Alex Bregman would be next. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Astros go down 1-2-3. They lead this one, though, 5-1. At the plate now is Nick Ahmed. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
Yeah, I think if I'm the hitting coach right here, Matty, I'm telling the offense to get aggressive. Just seems like we've been going too deep in counts, and this guy has got exploding stuff on the mound. So I would tell them get overly aggressive on a heater in the middle of the plate early.
First pitch on its way.
Ball inside.
One 0 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed, 1-1. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. The next 1-2 pitch. To third. Bregman gloves it. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Mookie Betts, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here, similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
2-0. Three and oh now. David Fletcher waits on deck. We're in the sixth inning now of a 5-1 ball game. Gets him to swing over the top of that one. 3-1. Hits this one hard the other way, and a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. He'll get it into second, and he'll reach second now with one away.
Well, the pitcher can't really worry about that one. I mean, it was only their second hit of the game, so he's doing a lot of things right. Let's see if he can leave him out there now.
into the box now. David Fletcher, as he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. No hits to this point. Off the plate and in. It's a ball and a strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Betts, the runner at second with one away. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball. The 2-1 home.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. And this is a strike three called. Oh, caught a break there. Two away.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
In now is Anthony Rendon. And he puts it on the ground to second. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And the run's going to score as they inch back a bit closer. It's now a 5-2 ball game.
Boy, talking about picking your teammate up after that strikeout, D-Row. Big, big, and I mean big, two-hard RBI single.
Yeah, way to come through for your team. When you take the donut off your bat right there, you're trying to pick up your teammate. He had the right game plan, didn't come outside it, stayed through the baseball and was able to come through.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. The 1-0 is swung on and missed, and that's strike one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Two runs, three hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
I'm seeing all the signs of fatigue right now. This is when you really have to bear down mentally as a pitcher.
Full count to Bellinger, three balls, two strikes.
Well, this has been a good at bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. He'll watch a sinker here that misses. It's ball one.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is crushed into left field, and this one ain't coming back. This ball is gone. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, number 22 on the year, as we are all tied at five. How about the work the lineups have been doing so far, fellas?
Matty V, this is turning into Home Run Derby Part 2. D-Ro, five bombs already in this one.
Yeah, there's a fight at the bat rack for both teams right here. A lot of mislocations right out over the heart of the plate, and neither side is missing.
Now here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change, as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So a no decision here this afternoon, as it'll be up to the bullpen from here on out. Christian Javier, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Into the box, Edwin Rios. As he'll watch a first pitch curveball drop in there for strike one. He went deep back in the fifth. The windup and the 0-1. Fouled off. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Tucker waits on it, and he makes the play to end the inning. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up, all even at five apiece. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
The third baseman, Alex Bregman.
First pitch on its way as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0.
Everything this guy throws moves. That two-seamer has a mind of its own.
Skied into straightaway right. Betts has a read on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The batter, number one.
Striding in is Carlos Correa, struck out in his last trip to the plate. Here's the first pitch to him. A bouncer up the middle. He's got it. And that's the second out. Next to dig in, Michael Brantley, a hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Now here's the first offering.
Hey, he's done an amazing job of settling down. Two innings ago, I thought they were going to run him out of here. But now he's close to posting two shutout innings as a response.
Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this is popped up near second base. Fletcher shading to his right, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. This remains a 5-all ball game. Now into the box, Max Muncy. For his career in this matchup, a number of meetings, he's one for seven. First pitch on the way.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Now the 0-1.
The beauty of that sequence right there, the fastball in, now to change up away, is where do you go as a hitter? Do you cover away? Do you cover the heater in? You can't do both. You have to pick a side of the plate and hope that's where he goes.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And another foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. 2-1. Bonnie gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. Full count now, 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And it's fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that means that Nick Ahmed will be the next to bat. From the belt, kicks and deals, and he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. To the left side, but it's well foul. Now the 1-1 pitch.
He's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
The 1-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Fastball just inside. Weak grounder back to the mound. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Time to get up and stretch here at Minute Maid Park. And we are all tied 5-5. New pitcher coming on now. And it's the former number one overall pick from 2007, David Price. Ready to take his hacks again. Alberto Ibarra blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat. First delivery to him. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Price has over 40 innings on his line so far. And when you look at his whip over those innings, it's not a particularly pretty number, over 1.5. So he's often dealing with a lot of traffic on the base paths, unfortunately. Now a good pitch on the inside part of the plate ties him up, and it's 1-1. Drilled to the left side. And that's going to get through into left. So there's your possible go-ahead run on base to lead off the inning.
That's why they call it a game of adjustments right there. The batter has to feel good about what he just did. Swung and missed at the first changeup, got it again, and was able to get himself a knock.
So now to the plate, Chris Taylor, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. 0 for 2 for him to this point. On the ground to third, fielded by Rendon to second for one, on to first, and you can forget about the go-ahead run being on base. He's erased on the double play.
Well, it was a promising start with the leadoff man on in a tie ball game, but there's nothing like a double play ball to change the course of an inning.
In now, Corey Lee. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. No hits to this point. The 1-0. Two out, nobody on. Nope. 3-0.
And how about the uncommon patience for the rookie in a big spot right here? These have been some tough pitches to lay off.
Lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Three of those pitches were definitely out of the zone, but that last pitch looked pretty darn good to me. You're not usually going to get many favorable calls on 3-0, though. You have to earn that spot.
Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. To the plate now, Kyle Tucker, as he'll take a look at ball one. He's 2 for 3 and looking for more here. The 1-0 is a low changeup that's laid off. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0. Miles Straw would be next. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And he'll try to check his swing here, but he'll have no such luck. It's strike one. Swinging a ball hit on the ground.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now the payoff pitch home. Into right field. That's a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
Hey, nice job all around right there. He's able to get a head start, full count, two outs. You know he's going right there. Batter didn't come out of his zone, no. Drove a nice single into the outfield. Now we got runners on first and third.
Up next, Miles Straw. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Now the first pitch here from Price. Runners at the corners, two men out. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off, one and two.
Big spot right here. That's a great pitch to try and see if you could get him to fish outside the zone. He's still in the driver's seat right now, and I'd expect something else to miss off the plate.
Here's the 1-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. A big-time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Played is Mookie Betts, and this tie ball game is a battle of the bullpens now, and I'm sure you're enjoying that, Dan.
Bullpens are such a big part of baseball now, Matt. All these teams have such good 7th, 8th, and 9th inning guys. It all boils down to whose bullpen is better.
First pitch of the AB now. Fooled him with that one as he's way out in front. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. Now to the plate, David Fletcher. Lifetime versus this pitcher, batting a robust 350. First pitch of the AB now.
Hey, a curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
The 1-0 home is chased out of the zone for strike one.
Hey, this offense is going to have to change their mindset. If they're going to get swing and misses on that slider, you know he's going to go to that well. They are going to have to be willing to take the ball the other way and stay back on that heater, or they are not going to recognize that pitch.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. Now this will rattle up against the wall. The relay throw, and it's in time as he's out at third as the good relay gets him.
Just a really poor decision to push it for three that time, guys. He represented the go-ahead run, and he has to know how important he is and stay at second base. That scoring position, you have to trust your guys can pick you up.
And digging in next will be Anthony Rendon, as he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. ready with the 1-2.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Two out, nobody on. Good battle. Count remains full. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring forward Cody Bellinger. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
He's set. The 0-1. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Dodgers leave one. This ball game still tied 5-all. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And striding forward, the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
And he falls behind 0-2. Price sets his sights. Here comes the pitch. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game.
Pretty textbook pitching right there. Jump ahead in the count 0-2, and then start working outside the zone. Easier said than done, but that's the way you do it.
And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half, it's 0-1. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Price ready with the 0-1. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
0-2 count. You could do just about anything you want right now. Up, down, in, out, hard, soft. Good time to be a pitcher.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to, and that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
Here's the first pitch to him. Swing and a shot toward right center. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. And your go-ahead run is in there at second base as he's got himself a two-out double.
Left fielder, Michael Brantley.
Corey Knebel enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Striding in for Houston, Michael Brantley. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. He's 1-for-5. First pitch coming. Here it is. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one. Ready with the 0-1. And now a curveball as he's got to lean out of the way. That one nearly got him. Fouled away. Now a fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Reaches out for one and hits it on the ground to second. He's right there. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. More from MLB Network, Saturday Baseball after this. And now here is Will Smith. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game. First delivery to him. There's a fastball right down Broadway, taken for a strike.
You know, most people would be surprised he took that right there because that looked like it was in his honey hole. He had to obviously be sitting on something else.
Two balls and a strike now. Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
Well, that's ball three. The Dodgers right now would love to start this inning off with a walk anyway to get this leadoff guy on.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. Ibarra trying to get there, and this is going to be a foul ball. Now the payoff pitch home. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
At the plate now, Edwin Rios. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. The 1-0 is on a line to left center, and it's going to fall, a base hit.
He doubled up on that one, Danny. Back-to-back changeups. Nice job by the batter right there, staying on that pitch.
That's one of the things that this pitcher will do, though, Mark. His changeup is so good, he's not afraid to throw it back-to-back pitches.
At the plate, Max Muncy, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. And it's quickly 0-2. changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. And he fouls this one off. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1 and 2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
Standing in now, Andrew Benintendi, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. The 1-0.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Now the 2-0. And that fastball's taken but catches the outer third.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
The set and the 2-2. Grounded down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And he strikes him out on a good pitch. So one run can win it as we head to the bottom of the inning. One left for LA. Our score holds at 5 apiece. Now it'll be Alberto Ibarra. He homered earlier and is 2 for 3 to this point. First pitch of the AB now as he hits one on a line to left field. Benintendi is there and he's got that all important first out here to start the ninth.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Into the box, Chris Taylor. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 1-1 home. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And there's out number two.
Now batting.
Next, it'll be Corey Lee. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. First pitch on its way as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. Swing and a liner. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here as this is a beauty to end the inning. More of MLB Network's Saturday Baseball after this. Joe Smith takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. Oh. We are into extra innings, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Nick Ahmed. Here's the first pitch. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. The 0-1. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. One and two.
I wouldn't be surprised if he used his aggressiveness against him right here. If you're going to get a swing outside the zone, 1-1, might as well fish a little bit further.
Now the 1-2 pitch. Skied into very shallow right. Tucker waits on it. He's got it one away. Big spot here, and it'll be Mookie Betts. And a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that would keep the game tied. Here's the first pitch. A swing and a high drive to right center field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Had to go a long way to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track data. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 120 feet to bring it in. No doubt that grab saved extra bases. Stepping in now, David Fletcher, as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. And he bats in a big spot here. Go ahead, run at third, two men out. And looked like the sinker here, but a good job of knocking this thing down. One and one. Here it is. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times or do I have to sit on something else?
So a full count now.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
Go ahead, runs in scoring position here with two down. Now here's a check swing and they appeal down to first. No swing. So that's ball four.
Oh, man, that check swing was about as close as they get. Tough call for the umpire, but it goes the batter's way this time, and he draws the walk.
So now to the plate, Anthony Rendon, as he'll take strike one on the inside corner. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. Runners on first and third, two away. In the dirt and block behind the plate. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. So the lead runner holds on, but the trailer will take second. The set and the 2-1. hit hard on the ground to second. And that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And a very important insurance run comes across to score from second. Now a 7-5 game.
Boy, we thought this one was going to go way into the night. That is a big base hit here in extra innings to give them the lead by two.
Yeah, Dan, you know as well as I do. It gets to the extra innings. Everybody's tries to go deep and end it with one swing and a bat. That's a nice job to stay within himself and drive in a pair.
Austin Pruitt takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Cody Bellinger at the plate now, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 0-1 pitch.
Boy, this is one of those ABs you like to hit the rewind button on. Put himself in a tough spot now, hitting with two strikes.
Weak grounder down the first baseline, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Opposite field to left, and he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. So it's two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left on. So now we'll see if these guys can get even in the bottom of inning number 10. Dodgers lead this one 7-5. Tommy Kahnle takes the ball, looking to make sure this game goes no further. Save situation here in inning number 10. Runner at second now. Nobody out. And in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
He's got to be more disciplined here. It's 0-2.
Got to believe you're going to get some tough pitches in this count with the base open at first. This is where you have to regroup and find a way to get a good pitch to drive in that run.
He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Those were two great executed pitches right there away from this batter. He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
Not what he wanted to do there with the slider as it misses well above the zone.
You know, in this situation, you almost have to pitch like there's no one on base. That run really doesn't mean anything with the lead they've got. The hitter is the guy that can turn this game on its head.
The 2-2. Now a ball lined hard toward right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And that's going to bring in the run from second to make this a one-run game now.
Well, the beat goes on with this guy, runner in scoring position. No doubt when he comes up, he's thinking RBI. What does he do? Double the drive in another run. This guy is a money run producer.
And now with the possible tying run at second here, we're going to have a pinched runner as they try to get a little more speed out there. Next to stand in is Miles Straw. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0-for-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
First delivery to him. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Daza stands at second with no outs. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with a slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
Set and the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a liner. And hold everything, folks, as this is going to tie the ball game. He's in at second safely as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
You know, D-Row, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late innings, so that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in the bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws under 97 miles an hour with sink and cut. That is unbelievable he's able to get that knock in that big spot.
At the plate now, Yordan Alvarez, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset closer can have a short-term memory, and this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic
third
on a base pass and
two.
Just attack the zone.
Alex Bregman.
Victor Gonzalez, a lefty standing 6 foot even, takes over the pitching duties here. Into the box now, Alex Bregman, as he'll send a ground ball down to third. Throw gets him, two down. Chance to walk it off, and now here is Carlos Correa. The winning run stands at second base. Here's the first pitch. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. Comes set, the 0-1. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. One pitch is a sinker taken for a strike, 1-2. One and two, here it is. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Bellinger is there to make the catch, and that means we've got more baseball ahead. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. And we'll have to cancel those dinner reservations, partner. 11th inning coming up. And we are tied 7-7. Jonathan Daza will stick around as he'll take over in right field. Runner at second now. Nobody out. And that brings up Will Smith. Here's the first pitch.
Nope.
Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. And a fastball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0.
Not even close with the 1-0. He needs to get back in the zone, but be careful. Work the quadrants.
Now the 2-0 tapped up the first baseline. Two and two to the Dodgers catcher. Two. shot towards second. Oh, and he misses it. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first.
Well, good fundamental baseball might just win him this ballgame. They had the go-ahead run at second base, so this guy knows exactly what he has to do. Just a simple ground ball to the right side gets that guy to third, and now all sorts of ways to take the lead.
Standing in now, Edwin Rios, as he will take a look at strike one on a fastball right down the pipe.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
Awfully close with the slider there, but it's one and one. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. A ball and two strikes now.
This is a situation where you're going strictly for the strikeout. Infield in, and from the offensive standpoint, you're just trying to create hard contact and get it by that infielder.
Lays off, two and two now. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and a big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now.
Now batting the first baseman.
Big at bat now, and here is Max Muncy. Needs a hit here to bring the go-ahead run home from third with two away. Here's the first pitch. Ball and a strike.
Hey, that's just a nice get me over curveball there to steal a strike. I don't think he was looking for that one.
Fouled off.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
Curveball knocked down at home plate, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. High in the air out to center field. Strom is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Dodgers leave one, still tied 7-7. Next up is Michael Brantley. The winning run stands at second base.
Michael Brantley.
Here's the first pitch. The 1-0. Now a drive to right field. This could do it. Game over. Walk-off home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
9-7, the final score in this ballgame. Houston get the win on the heels of four home runs. Austin Pruitt earns his third win of the year in relief. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vasgersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Astros, 9 runs, 12 hits. No errors, they left 5 men on base. For the Dodgers.